surrenders Tumbutumbu Garden owes the town council $5,000, which he said he made arrangements to settle after selling his produce. About 3,500 plants of tomatoes, butternuts, and several plots of onions were lost due to the water disconnection. This is how the garden looked like in November during our visit, all green, and Saranda anticipating a good harvest. Those hopes have been dashed.
It's a very huge loss. Starting with the cost of seeds, I spent nearly 25,000, then add the different fertilizers I used, pesticides, and paying workers, and other expenses on preparing the garden. It's a lot of money, but I knew I could have recovered the money from the sales. I could have raised more than 200,000 from my investments.
He expected to start marketing tomatoes to supermarkets, hostels, and street vendors this January before he was dealt the blow. His wife, Hildegard Shimafo, says villagers who were employed at the garden are also at a loss as their salaries were to be paid from the harvest.
We started this garden not for ourselves only, but for the whole community as well. We are talking of Kavango being a poor region, and by engaging in farming, we are contributing to fighting poverty instead of waiting on government alone.
Shimafo added that vendors making an income from selling tomatoes on the streets are also affected. She is furious at the town council's action, saying it owes the family $33,000 for the use of their water pump. They now demand the town council to immediately settle the invoice issued to them since last year. Contacted for comment, Kurenkuru Acting Chief Executive Officer Paulus Shihinga said the council will deliberate on Saranda's matter at its first sitting next week and provide clarity. Chris Kupulo, NBC News, Kurenkuru.